Hello, and welcome to ESET versus Advanced Persistent Threats. In this video, we'll be going through three different attack scenarios where an attacker tries to infiltrate a company. All of the attacks you see here are mapped to the MITRE ATT&CK framework. The first attack vector is the easiest attack vector, which is email. And in this attempt, he's going to utilize a spear phishing attachment where he pretends to be the chief financial officer. He, of course, attaches some sort of malicious document, and then he's going to send it out to a wide range of users at a specific company, hoping that at least one user will open up the email that contains the malicious attachment. But in this instance, the users are running ESET mail security with ESET Dynamic Threat Defense. And ESET Dynamic Threat Defense is our cloud sandbox. So whenever there is a potential threat or something that it's unsure about, it can send it up to our cloud sandbox for analysis. And in this situation, when the analysis runs, we notice that there is some sort of malicious content contained in that attachment. The resulting information is sent down to the endpoint, letting the user know that that email that he received that looked like it was from the chief financial officer might not have been from them because it contained a malicious attachment that was blocked by ESET Dynamic Threat Defense. On the remote administrator side, where the administrator will go in, manage all of the different endpoints, we can see similar information. We can see that ESET Dynamic Threat Defense was the protection layer that stepped in and blocked the potential threat. The administrator can get even more details reading a full file behavior report that lets him know exactly why a specific item was detected as malicious. What we'll do next is we will try the next attack vector, because this is usually where the attacker goes next. Email failed, he wasn't able to get through, so now what they do is they leave USB devices all over our company's organization. Maybe they'll go on a tour and drop flash drives in the parking lot, hoping that users will plug them into a computer. With an ESET protected computer, however, when a user plugs in a flash drive into a computer, access is denied. And this is due to ESET's device control. In that situation, you saw that pop up on the user's screen, but from the administrator's standpoint, what we can see is exactly that information. The user tried to plug in a flash drive, what computer was he on, what type of drive was it, and whether the device was allowed or blocked. But in order to better simulate a persistent attack, because an attacker would keep trying more and more to bypass technologies, we'll turn off ESET device control. Now a user plugs in the device, he has the option to scan or not scan the device, and as we know, everyone chooses don't scan. He then sees an interesting document on that flash drive and they try and open it. And what do they find is a blank document, and immediately we see ESET let us know that there was an exploit contained in that document. So there was a payload contained in there that tried to launch, but ESET stepped in and blocked it. From the administrator standpoint, we can see similar information that we noticed that there was a Trojan in there, and ESET stepped in and noticed what was happening, and we actually went ahead and blocked it. We're going to go a step further, and we're going to disable our DNA detections now, once again continuing to simulate that persistent attack that might happen. User does all of the same things that they did before, except this time when the document is open, we see another layer of protection step in and stop this attack from happening. And what actually pops up from ESET is it's letting us know that Microsoft Word tried to launch a suspicious application. And this is a portion of our HIPS module that notices that something weird is going on, because Microsoft Word should not be launching these weird applications. And that was actually our exploit blocker that did that level of protection during the execution stage. This attacker really is persistent, so they're going to keep on trying to get into this organization. Now that we've disabled these layers of protection, this malware tries to communicate out with its command and control server. And now ESET says, we notice that something weird's going on in the network. Something's trying to communicate out to a bad address. And we terminate the connection. We do not allow the connection to complete. And now we can hop in on the management server side and see all of the details that would give you the information needed to put new rules in your firewall or adjust any layers of protection that you might want. Let's turn off ESET's web access protection now so that the command and control communication fully occurs. And so now what it's doing is it's trying to download an extra payload onto the system. Usually a first thing that malware tries to do is they try and gain persistence on a computer. And that's exactly what this malware is doing. So we can see all of this information happening by hopping into ESET Enterprise Inspector, which is our endpoint detection response tool. And we can see the exact chain of events that's happened. Microsoft Word was opened, PowerShell was launched, W.exe was launched. And then we can see at the bottom that file association was changed by an unpopular process. That is usually a dead giveaway for an attempt to gain persistence on a machine. We can dive even deeper into the details of anything contained in here, and we can see right here that we notice that W.exe was doing some weird communication as well as modifying registry keys. So not only did we see ESET step in during that communication, but we also see it on our EDR side as well. Now we're going to continue on with this attack. And this attacker is going to try and still communicate with that command and control server. But on the endpoint side, we notice that something weird is going on in our botnet protection, which not only stops botnets, but any sort of command and control malware steps in and notices that a weird communication is going on and kills it. And this is a component of our firewall contained in ESET Endpoint Protection Advanced. And we can see all of the respective information contained in ESET Security Management Center to give you even more details about this specific attack. Now what we'll do is we'll disable botnet protection and we'll let this attack continue further. Everything happens as it did before, where that USB drive is connected. And now what's going to happen is the attacker wants to gain information about the network. He's going to download something called Nmap and scan the entire network looking for important machines. And in this specific instance, he notices a Mac computer. And when you find a Mac computer, usually that means that there's probably someone important using that Mac. So he's going to specifically target that Mac. And from our management server side of things, we can see both a TCP port scanning attack happening on any computer that contains the ESET firewall. And in the EDR side, we can see that a port scanning attack was underwent as well. And so we can see exactly where that attack is coming from. But like I mentioned, he noticed that there is a Mac computer in the organization. There's a web server in the organization. So now he's going to try and download a payload. Final payload, Memcached. He wants to be able to dump those credentials from the computer, and he's going to download that payload onto the computer. But even though we've disabled all of these layers of ESET's protection, still, ESET steps in, notices that there was a threat while it was in memory, and kills the threat, and actually cleans it by deleting. On the management server side of things, we can see the same information that this threat was deleted, and it was deleted by our advanced memory scanner, which can detect not just threats in memory, but what we typically call fileless threats. So that attacker tried to get onto the organization via email first, the easiest method. Then they tried to get on via USB attacks. We disabled lots of layers of protection to try and allow him to get further and better simulate that advanced persistent attack. Now he's going to try and infiltrate that web server that they saw earlier. And he's going to try and utilize a CVE on that web server because it was unpatched. But ESET steps in here, notices that an attempted exploit was happening on this web server, and we stop it. So let's allow this attacker to go further. We'll turn off network attack protection. And now this attacker is going to keep trying to gain access to this organization. So he's going to use a bunch of different attack techniques to get there. But ultimately what they're doing is they're utilizing PowerShell to deliver a payload via SSH or PSExec to the remote machines, hoping to drop a piece of ransomware on those devices. Like I mentioned, this Mac, very important. He tried to infiltrate that with ransomware, but as you saw the pop-up from ESET, we stopped it. So even though that all of these layers of protection have been disabled within ESET, we're still stopping these threats. And this is very, very important to have those layers of protection when you are dealing with advanced persistent threats. Because they might get through one layer, especially if they keep attempting. They might get through a second layer. But if you keep having these layers of protection to stop different sort of exploits or attack vectors, then that better helps protect you against any sort of persistent attack. We can see on the Windows machine that a separate layer of protection stepped in. This is actually our ransomware shield specifically that stepped in. Notice that there was a potential threat, and we can see that notated in the ESET Security Management Center here. Of course, as with any threat, as you've seen previously, we can notice all of the different details about what we know about this specific threat. We can hop over to our EDR system, ESET Enterprise Inspector, and we can follow the entire chain of events that has happened. So this is great for your investigations. This is great to provide you information to understand what happened so that you can better protect yourselves in the future. It is always not just enough to go and stop it. You need to be able to prevent this sort of thing from happening in the future and better up your defenses to withstand these advanced persistent attacks. So we can see here, PowerShell executed, command prompt executed. They tried to execute that file coder or ransomware attack. And we can see all of that laid out exactly here. So you know not just how the attack happened or what the attack was, but you know that entire chain of events so you can put the extra layers of protection or tweak firewalls to better protect your organization from an advanced persistent attack.